It's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Hey there, Eagles. Welcome to school on Monday, February 8th.
Let's kick off the week by turning to Mrs. DeClerc's class for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. Ready? Begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, Ms. Deckler's class. Job well done. Let's see what's happening at Armstrong this week.
Thanks for the update. Let's check what sort of weather we're having this week.
So this was the weather last week. And today is going to be mostly sunny and it's 37 degrees. And on Tuesday it's going to be sunny also and it's at 40 degrees. And on Wednesday, it is going to be sunny and 40 in the 40s the rest of the week.
Thanks for the update. Let's check out another weekly whip around.
Thank you.
Wow, cool stuff. Thanks for sharing. Let's turn to Mr. Goble to find out some information about Moonbugs.
A moonbug.
Thanks, Mr. Goble. We are certainly excited about getting some moonbugs. Next week, we have SCP conferences and the annual book fair. Let's have a look.
Awesome, we can't wait to get in there. It's time for another update from the Armstrong Community Council.
At the January meeting of the Armstrong Academy Community Council, the council was updated on the progress of Armstrong's application for the official STEM designation by the State Office of Education. 6 of the 10 sections have been completed, and it is expected that all sections will be completed by February 5th. The application will then be reviewed and finalized by the Armstrong Committee working on it up until the final application deadline on February 18th. Another honor could be coming Armstrong's way. The school was nominated by the Utah State Office of Education as a Blue Ribbon School. This is a federal designation, and only 3 schools in Utah have been nominated by the state office to compete for this recognition to get the award. Armstrong Academy has to equal or exceed last year's SAGE testing results. Only 5 schools in Utah have been designated Blue Ribbon Schools since 1982, so it would be a great achievement for Armstrong if it received the award. The amendment to Armstrong's current land trust plan was approved by the Granite School Board at its January meeting. In part, the amendment enables Armstrong to hire multiple paraeducators to facilitate the reading program for kindergarten, first, and second grades. They will help track student progress of students' reading abilities and allow for small group time for the certified teachers to provide the direct intervention to students who are not reading on grade level. The council at its February meeting will begin discussing the 2016-2017 School Land Trust Plan, which must be submitted in March. We'll look at what the budget for the plan will be and begin developing the plan accordingly. The next community council meeting will be February 18th at 4 p.m. at the school. Anyone is welcome to attend. If you have any questions, comments, or concern about what goes on at Armstrong, feel free to contact any community council member. Our contact information is found at armstrongacademy.org and click on the community council at the top of the page. Thanks for listening.
Thanks for the great information. Let's check in our reading blast off.
I read The Elephant and Pig. He says you should read it because it's funny, and it's really funny because Gerald thinks that he's allergic to Peggy, but he isn't. He's just getting a cold.
I read the A to Z mystery series. I liked that there were kids who solved mysteries and in the same grade as me. Last, I liked it because one of the kids' names was Josh, and he always had to eat. And one of the books, Josh said that detective work makes me hungry. I think you should read it if you like mysteries.
I am here with Ben Eberle. He has finished his 25th book series, so I'm here to present him with his 25 blast off reading blast off pin. There you go, Ben. Good job. Great reading. I am here in Mrs. Christensen's class to present an award or a button to Miss Sami, who completed her 25th book series. So this is for you, Miss Sami. Good job. Great reading. Let's give her all a library clap. Good job, Miss Sami. Way to go.
Thanks, readers. Keep up the good work.
That's it for us. Thanks for watching.
This is ABC News.